Our series for the last couple months has been His Love, My Reward, and My Response. So tonight is week one of My Reward. Now, who can tell me what our three words are for the year? Faith, family, and focus. Hey, if you're new to Choose Life, we want to give you this little brochure that's going to kind of give you a little bit of an idea of what we mean by faith, family, and focus. Have you guys ever seen a movie trailer? Okay, pretty much everybody. What's the purpose of a movie trailer? To kind of show you what's coming, right? To show you, like, how many of you guys have ever watched a trailer and it was like it was the whole movie? That's the worst. Do you know the fun fact about Pastor Greg? Raise your hand if you want one of these. Pastor Greg does not like trailers at all. You know why? Because it's like it's the whole movie. And so he's like, if it looks good, let's just watch it. I'm like, no, watch the trailer with me. He was like, no, because then I'm going to see the whole movie. I'm going to have an idea of what's going to happen. No, if you think it looks good, we'll just do it. Guys, this is kind of like the trailer for the entire year, okay? Because when we build our life on the Word of God, and just go there, go to Luke chapter 6, and if you don't know where that is, they'll put it on the screen. Y'all give it to me in the King James in the back. Luke chapter 6, verses 46 through 49. Because here at Choose Life, we're all about the Word. Because the Bible says in Matthew 24:35 that heaven and earth will pass away, but the Word will not pass away. How do you get saved? You have to hear the Word. Somebody has to tell you what that book says about what Jesus did for you. If you don't know what Jesus did, how can you serve Him? How can you please Him? But yet there's a whole world that has no idea who God is. How many of you guys have ever heard the phrase, God's in control? Anybody ever heard that? How many of you guys believe that? If you do, that's okay. It's just not in the Bible. God's not in control. If God's in control, then why are thousands and millions and billions, I mean, I don't even know, unborn babies killed every single year? God's not in control of that. The Bible says in Jeremiah 1:5 that He knew you while you were in your mother's womb. So He just decided certain ones didn't need to see life? I don't think so. Right? How many people are raped? How many people die on, oh, like, I think in the last year, there were over 100,000 fentanyl overdoses. Fentanyl, whatever. I hate drugs. I hate everything about drugs. That whole system. It's just such a cheap counterfeit for what can happen when you really get into this Word and you really get into the presence of God. Over 100,000 people die on fentanyl. Fentanyl. Why do I keep saying it wrong? Whatever. Who cares? Did God do that? That was God's plan, God's idea. No, God is not in control. He's given you control. He's given you power, and you have to choose life or death. And choosing life or death starts with choosing to make Jesus the Lord of your life. But once you do that, you've got to build your life on what He says. You can never pass math studying your history book. You're not going to pass math being good at history. You get a math test, and all you do is write a bunch of dates and facts about Alexander Graham Bell and Thomas Jefferson, and your teacher's like, what is this? It's like, well, this is my history. Okay, well, too bad. This is math, right? You never pass Spanish talking in French. Okay, if you're going to be successful in life, you've got two options to build your life on: the Word of God or the kingdom of darkness. And y'all, the kingdom of darkness, they're just ig. You know what ig stands for? Ignorant. Ignorant, right? Things they do doesn't make sense. Okay, I'm going to tell you right out. If you're born with a wee-wee, you're a boy. If no one's ever told you that, I need you to know that tonight, and I need you to write that down. Because there's a lot of confusion about that. Okay? If you don't have one, you're a girl. I don't care what you feel like. I don't care what someone told you. Right? There's so much confusion about you, about your purpose, about your plan. Why? Because if you don't build your life on this, what about this whole idea that we came from monkeys? You might have come from a monkey, but I didn't come from a monkey. That's fine. That's fine. If you want to believe you came from a monkey, right? Big Bang Theory, this evolution, all of it is designed to eliminate God from existence. You can't eliminate Him. He was here before you got here. And so you're going to have to decide a life built on faith or a life based on feelings. And right now, you're literally buying in to either a life built on faith or a life built on someone's feelings. Do you know that all the music that you listen to is literally someone's feelings to music? Everything you listen to is how someone feels about life. Have you ever listened to, like, Like, give me like an old school one, because I don't want to like pop your balloon. Do you know what I'm saying? So like, give me a little bit of achy breaky heart, guys. Give me a little achy breaky heart, just a little bit. Do you got any country music fans in here? Me either. I don't like country music, but it's just like the first one. It's the first one that came to my mind. A little achy breaky heart. You're gonna feel like chopping your ears off because it's such bad music you don't want to listen to it, right? Because you know, who likes country in here? Like four people, couple white people. Okay, Before He Cheats. Give me Before He Cheats. Okay, you listen to this song, you want to go post on somebody. No one's ever cheated on me, right? Well, I don't do that kind of drama. You know what I'm saying? But every time I listen to this, y'all. Just tell me somebody cheated. I'll come after your car on your behalf. See, we don't drink. We don't go to bars. We don't do this. Right? You listen to this, and all of a sudden, you enter into their world. That's not my world. He don't know that I dug my key into the side of his pretty. I've never done that. Never done that. Into his leather seat. There's a lot of you that know this. You mad teenagers. Okay. Give me Blown Away. Okay. The thing about it is, like, you step into their world. Right, you step into their world. Every time I listen to that song, I think I'm like a little bad girl and I can just go crazy on something. I can't. I'm not a bad girl. I couldn't probably even key a car right. Do you guys know the backstory to this? This is horrible. It's the last one, so you better enjoy it. Mister. The wind in Oklahoma. Out of his house. Okay, bottom line. This is like a really, really bad dad. That does really bad things to his daughter. And she's glad that the tornado blew the house down and killed him in it. Okay, that, like, it's got a cool vibe, but we're talking about daddy's gone, daddy's bad, the tornado came, blew it all. Do you understand? You step into their world. Right now, guys, you are living based on the choices that you make. Just like I said, like, people who have a wee-wee that don't think that they're a boy, that think that they're a girl, you stepped into somebody else's version of truth. Okay? So that's like sinking sand. It's constantly changing. What was cool 5 years ago isn't cool today. There's no stability in that system. You know why? Because the enemy is the author of confusion. He's the author of fear, which means he's a master at deception. The Bible says he's the father of all lies. So when you build your life on that system, there's no stability whatsoever. But when you build your life on the word of God, the Bible says in Luke chapter 6, verse 47, whoever comes to me and hears my sayings and does them, I will show you what he's like. He's like a man who built a house and dug deep, laid the foundation on a rock, and when the flood rose, the stream beat vehemently upon the house. Guys, there's pressure. There's things that we face. But when you build your life on the word of God, it gives you the victory, right? It enables you to overcome the hardest of heartache, the hardest struggles, the hardest insecurities, whatever you're facing, the word of God will give you the victory over it. But if you choose to just live in your feelings, right? Everybody's got feelings. We all face insecurities. We all face the opportunity to be fearful, to feel rejected. But you've got to decide, you know what? I believe the word of God over what people have done to me. I believe the word of God over whatever situation I'm facing. And really tonight, you've got to know that one of your rewards, two of them, in relationship with God is protection and peace. Write it down. Protection and peace are yours in Christ Jesus. Now, if you've not made Jesus the Lord of your life, we're going to give you the opportunity to make that decision tonight. But if you've already made Jesus the Lord of your life, you have access to protection and peace. When I got married to Greg, everything that he had belonged to me. Right? I don't ask him, hey, can I use the card? No. I don't ask him, hey, can I use the truck? I mean, I don't like that truck. That truck is huge. You know what I'm saying? I've only driven that a couple times. It's too big. It's too big for my life. But I don't have to ask him permission for the things because we have a covenant. Okay, you have a covenant with God. And there's certain benefits that you get in his love. And two of them are protection and peace, which is why I wanted you to focus in your small groups on things that you've been fearful of. Because in Christ Jesus, you don't have to fear that. Now, if you want to, okay, fine. Let's just go blow up the car, you know, blow up the tornado, whatever. Achy breaky, whatever. Like, I can't change your feelings for you. Just like you can't change mine. Okay, you face pressures, I face pressures, but you got to decide. At the end of the day, are you going to believe the word of God or are you going to be a crybaby? Okay, if things are going on, you need to talk, let's talk about them. If you're not safe, if you're with people who are abusing you and hurting you, we need to talk about it. Okay, but after that, you need to put on your big girl underwear and you need to like take the word of God as true. Right? Because nobody can do that for you. And the same Jesus that died for me died for you. And in his love, there is protection and peace. Look at these verses. They'll be on the screen. Proverbs 1, 29 through 33. For you closed your eyes to the facts and did not choose to reverence and trust the Lord. See, when you do things his way, things don't happen that happen to other people. Like, I'm thinking about my friend who died right after she completed her seventh grade year. Okay? Was she in the will of God? No. She barely made time for youth group. Was she praying in the Holy Ghost? No. Her grandma, not in church, but the Holy Spirit prompted her, hey, don't let her go on that trip. Her dad, in and out of church, whatever, prompted him, don't let her go on that trip. Her sister, who doesn't even live here, had a dream that she died in a plane crash. Still let her go on the trip. What happened? I say goodbye to her the last day of school. We just finished our seventh grade year. She gets in the car. She's the only one that dies in the accident. She flew from the vehicle. She's gone, right? But she's too busy for church because she's got cheerleading. She's got all this other stuff. I'm begging her all the time, come to youth group, come to youth group, come to youth group. Okay, well, that same thing's not going to happen to me. I've been on that same road that she died on multiple times, thousands of times, right? I'm not vulnerable like she's vulnerable. Why? Because she's out of the will of God. Okay, the kid that we buried in 2010, that was on the Lovington Highway that like turned his car into a bullet. How fast was he going? He was going over 100 miles an hour between here and Lovington. He wasn't drunk, was he? He was just driving like an idiot. It's debatable. Regardless, right? He set himself up. You can't drive like that. You can't drive like that. See, there is a reward for being in the will of God. There's a reward for reverencing God. What does it mean to reverence God? It means to honor him. It means to do things his way. See, you're a little disrespectful, your little attitude, your little not honoring God and doing whatever you want, that doesn't go well for you. You get outside of his protection. But if you honor him and you honor his word, you will be protected. There are things that happen to people that will never happen to me. There are things that people have to experience and they have to go through. I'm not going to go through those things. Why? Because I honor the Lord. There's a benefit to doing things God's way. And that's what this verse says. You turned your back on me, spurning my advice. That's why you must eat the bitter fruit of having your own way and experience the full terrors of the pathway you've chosen. Because you've turned away from me to what? To death. Your own complacency will kill you. But all who listen to me, say that's me. That was like four people. Are the rest of y'all going to enjoy the bitter fruit of having your own way and experience the full terrors of the path you've chosen? I hope not. Okay, let's try it again. But all who listen to me, say that's me.
That's me.
They will live in peace and safety and unafraid. Write down a couple of thoughts before I give you a little bit of an illustration. Your way doesn't leave a good taste in your mouth. Your way will not leave a good taste in your mouth. It might feel so good right now. Because you're like, little homecoming queen, little homecoming king. You're like on the top of your little high school game. But if you're doing things your own way, that's not going to leave a good taste in your mouth. And I don't mean just like a little bit of bad breath. I mean, you open yourself up. Guys, honestly, and write this down. It's not on the screen. Like, being forgiven is easy. But being restored, that's a process. What does that mean? You can do wrong things right now and be forgiven. But it takes time for your soul to be restored. You run around, do the hanky-panky with people you ain't married to, you can be forgiven for that. But man, that creates scars in your soul that you have to deal with. And that in many cases, you can even take into your marriage. It's not worth it. You get delivered from drugs, well, then you got to believe for your brain to come back. Do you know what I'm saying? I have a friend, he makes me laugh. He's married, and he smoked a lot of weed when he was in high school. And he's like, every once in a while, he'll just be like, man, it's just like faded, you know? He doesn't remember stuff. He doesn't live that life anymore. You know, he's married, he has a family, he has a career. But like, he feels deficient in his brain. His story, not mine, right? He feels deficient in his brain. Now, I believe you can believe God for restoration, but I'm just saying, like, it's just like, it's all fun right now. But the payday on all of that is coming. Romans 6:23 says the wages of sin is death. But listen to this, for you, this, those who listen to me will live in peace and safety, unafraid. Everyone say unafraid. Peace means, write this down, nothing missing, nothing broke. Do you know that there's a lot of wealthy people that don't have peace? Because wealth won't fix your soul. Wealth won't fix your soul. Doesn't matter how nice your car is, how great your rims are, how big your car is, how fly your girl is. If you ain't right with him, you ain't right. And when you go to bed at night, you know it in between your ears. It doesn't matter how successful you are at all kinds of other stuff. Right? Peace is nothing missing, nothing broke. It's so much bigger than possessions. It's eternal confidence. I'm not talking about eternal security. Guys, eternal security is about making Jesus the Lord of your life. If you've believed in your heart and confessed with your mouth the Lord Jesus, you're going to heaven. But there's a lot of believers that don't have eternal security in the sense, or eternal confidence in the sense that, like, what are you taking to eternity? Okay, your little polo stats, water polo stats. You like how I use water polo because then I didn't isolate anybody because nobody in here plays water polo. See how I did that? I'm on your team. I could have used a lot of other stats. You're not taking those little trophies with you. Your little water polo trophies. Okay, you're not taking, you want me to use your stuff, your little gaming? No one cares in eternity. I'm not saying there's not time to play water polo. I'm not saying there's not time to play the game. But when all that stuff is more important than his kingdom, you got a major problem on your hands. You're not going to have eternal confidence. You're going to stand before him at the end of your life and be like, well, I was like at church a couple times. I was like, I just was so busy. Like, busy with what? You're going to look into his face with the holes in his hand and say you were too busy? I can't with that. If that's really your story, I love you. But I would rewrite. I would get started on some new material. Okay, because this, we're not playing games here. This is not 6 years of your life just to blow and have fun and experiment. Okay, I've seen all of that. I can really handle, like, without being nauseous. Okay, because then you've got the first 5 years of your 20s to try to sort things out. And in many cases, people never get it sorted out. And they go right back to that vomit they were living in during high school and middle school. So don't play games with me because I'm not playing games. If you want peace and if you want protection, you got to do things his way. And it's not hard. There's a benefit to doing things his way. Now, you're going to have the bitter fruit of doing things your own way. Write this down. Terror isn't out of the realm of your control. Just like I said, like that guy, do you think that guy was like an on-fire Christian that was driving 100 miles an hour? You think it was committed and focused in youth group? He wasn't. Gosh, I loved him. That wrecked their family. That wrecked their family. Honestly, that puts more strain on a marriage than anything else. Even infidelity, meaning even cheating, is when parents lose a kid. Most couples don't survive that. They can survive cheating easier than losing a kid. So that was challenging, right? Not cool to do teenage funerals. Okay, the other one, I mean, that was more recent, but you just get hit in a car, get run over. You get run over in a parking lot of a restaurant, just messing around. You just get run over because kids are messing around. You get run over, messing around in a parking lot. And you've gone to youth camp here at this church. You've made Jesus the Lord of your life, but you got a little rainbow on your little arrangement for your casket. I'm just like, what in the actual world? You can't be gay. Not because you don't feel gay. Your feelings have nothing to do with it. You can't practice an alternative. And listen, fornication involves homosexuality as much as it involves sex outside of marriage. So don't be throwing rocks when you've not been walking the straight and narrow in your purity with someone of the opposite sex, because God looks at all that the same. It's all perversion of his plan, right? But was she involved in youth group? She had been. You don't want to do those funerals. But see, you can position yourself where terror is not, that doesn't happen to me. I don't fear car accidents. I don't fear disease. I don't fear dying early. I don't fear getting struck by lightning. Fill in the blank of whatever you fear. I don't have to fear that, because my reward for honoring him is protection. I have a reward. That's why there's so much to this relationship, so much more than eternity. Now, I need a couple people that want to just prove to me that bitter does not taste good in your mouth. Three people that are brave, just come on up here. First three people, go ahead and just put this in your mouth. Let's give them some, give us the best bitter song that they can. You each get your own bowl, brother. That's all you right there. Just take as much of that as you want. Turn around. Maybe guess what that is. If not, they all do it. All do it at the same time. Just get some of that. It's a good face right there. Good face. Good face. How's that treating you? You want some more? You want some more? Do y'all need a trash can? Do you want to spit it out? All the bitter people said. You guys good? You glad you came up tonight for that?
But right now I don't care about that part.
Y'all are going to have some ratchet breath. They're going to have the worst breath in this whole room. Yeah, big round of applause. I think we're done with these guys. They just ate a bowl full of dill. Dill is an herb. It's really good in small doses, but it's bitter. It's not good like that. All right, who's next? Here you go, young man. Okay, first three. You guys can be on standby right over here for the next one. All right, go ahead and just drop that down your mouth, guys. Tastes like lettuce. That one's kale, right? Kale's pretty bitter. It's a superfood, though, so you guys are going to be super healthy. Not that bad? I don't think it's as bad as dill. Yes, thank you so much. Big round of applause. Kale was kind of easy. All right, I need one more for this last one. All right, there you go. Okay. Go ahead, guys. Are you okay, Elijah? What do you guys have? Do you guys know? It's dark chocolate. Dark chocolate, so it has no sugar, which I really like dark chocolate, and dark chocolate is good for you, but it's definitely not sweet, right? There's nothing sweet about that. You know who would really have a hard time with this? Janiyah. She doesn't like chocolate at all. Who ever heard of a chocolate who doesn't like chocolate? Not me, until I met her. You guys, you need to get, what, you can't share? You gotta eat all the bitter of your ways right now. All the bitter of your ways. Hannah's already done.
I dug my key into the side of this pretty little souped up four-wheel drive. Carved my name into it.
You guys want some more? Here's the thing. We ain't got all day, bro. Good job. You are dismissed. Big round of applause for the dark chocolate eaters. I feel like that first one was the worst. Sour, absolutely. Guys, and that's how your life turns out. It just goes soured. It just goes the wrong direction when you do things your way. And then you have to justify it. Then you have to fake it and act like it's all good. Right? Like it's okay. You know what song I like? And you guys may not know this one. But basically, anytime people walk away from the Lord and they start doing their own thing, this is my jam for them. And it's called, just give it to them. I'm not even going to tell them what it's called. It's also country. I don't even like country music. But I guess their song, country music has the best bitter songs. Is that right? Everyone's like, eh? Emo music with a better sound. While they're pulling that up, look at Proverbs 2:20. It says, follow the steps of the godly and stay on the right path. For only good men, say only good men, enjoy life to the full. See, it's all a lie. It's all a lie that God, that life gets worse in church. It's all a lie that, like, with rules and boundaries and order in your life, that you're going to be worse off. You're not going to be worse off. You're going to be better off. It's when you do your own thing. It's when you walk after the flesh that you experience destruction. The Bible says the way of the transgressor is hard. Not doing things God's way. See, doing things God's way has benefits. There's protection for you. Y'all, several years ago, I was in the vehicle with somebody. Trish was with me. There was like four of us. And we were on our way to the movies in Midland. And we were with an absolute idiot. We didn't know how big of an idiot they were at the time, but they were definitely an idiot. And they were driving. And they're not in the will of God. Now, they're in our car, but they are not in the will of God. Okay? They're not in the will of God. But we are in the will of God. And God knows our heart. And we didn't know that they weren't in the will of God. Because they have like a double life. You know, people be doing that. They be having a double life and you don't know about it until all things hidden are revealed. And honestly, we should have gotten in a car accident. Right, Trish? Pastor Greg was in the car. I was in the car. I don't think Heather was in the car. Yeah, we should. Yeah, there's us rolling. Goodbye. You see me rolling. But not like that. Okay, wasn't that kind of rolling? It was like rolling into glory, right? Because this idiot was driving. And honestly, he knew it. But by the grace of God, right, because we're in the flow, God spared our life, right? Now, I don't advise that, but honestly, we were ignorant to the depths of what was going on in his world, right? When you get in the car with people, Pastor Greg's mom spared his life. He wanted to go to the YMCA with one of his friends who was doing community service. So you already know that guy ain't in the will of God. He's got community service. Coming to church, being fake, blowing up people's houses, throwing stuff, just vandalizing stuff. Bad kid. He was a bad kid, right? Pastor Greg isn't in the car that day. He begged his mom to go to the YMCA. She said, no, that guy is goners. Car accident, bye. Pastor Greg could have been in that car, right? But his mom knew better. No, you ain't getting in the car with that guy. He ain't on the straight and narrow. We didn't know that the guy we were with wasn't on the straight and narrow. God protected us. But I'm just telling you, when you aren't wise and you don't stay on the path, you stay on the path, okay? When you walk away, this is what you got to know. Listen to this one.
Just too bad you already have the best.
When you walk away, just know you already had the best days of your life. That's what I say. Everything's going downhill from here. You've already had the best days. You've already had the best days. When you walk out of the will of God into your own plan, the best days of your life are behind you. Thank you, guys. DJ Kaswizzy. I just made that up. Her name's Carol. Do y'all like that? Kaswizzy. All right. Follow the steps of the godly. Stay on the right path, for only good men enjoy life to the full. Evil men, and guys, here's the deal. When people walk away, let them go. Let them go. Do not text them tonight and say, hey, listen to this message. That this message isn't for them. They already had a chance to hear messages like this. Put your phone away right now if that's what you're doing. This ain't for them. They already had messages like this. This is for you. Okay, because when we ain't a cult. People walk out that door, we let them go. We ain't keeping anybody here. We ain't convincing them Jesus didn't do that. We don't do that. Evil men lose the good things they might have had, and they themselves shall be destroyed. Hence, you've already had the best days of your life. Enjoying life is about what path you choose. Guys, there's only two paths. There's the right one and the wrong one. There's no gray. There's only two paths, the right way and the wrong path. So enjoying life isn't about how much money you have. It's not about having a boyfriend. You know, I was talking to a young adult recently who's like, I just felt like as long as I had a boyfriend in high school that I would, like, I was secure. You're messing around with guys in the most vulnerable and awkward years of their life when they're in between being a boy and being a man, and you're going to get your security from that? Girl, please. Why are you putting that kind of pressure on him? Y'all just be friends. Y'all be friends. Keep it all on the up and up. You know what I mean? Go to Big Cheese, play the games, have the air hockey tournament, do something. Okay, but when you're soloing off like that and you think you met your soulmate, okay. Proverbs 3, don't be conceited, sure of your own wisdom. Instead, trust and reverence the Lord. So what's the opposite of honoring the Lord? Being prideful. Turn your back on evil. When you do that, then you will be given renewed health and vitality. The man who knows right from wrong, has good judgment and common sense, is happier than the man who is immensely rich. For such wisdom is far more valuable than precious jewels. Nothing else compares with it. Wisdom gives a long, good life, riches, honor, pleasure, and peace. Can money do that? No. Money can't give you a long, good life. Well, why did Steve Jobs, how old was Steve Jobs when he died? Too young. 67? He was not. He was 60-something. Someone Google it. How old was he? I'll be there in the back of your mind when the baby man. 56. He's a bazillionaire, right? But that ain't enough to keep you alive, right? Only wisdom will give you a long and a good life and riches and honor and pleasure and peace. See, it's not what you have, but it's how you got it. I love people. The only reason I mention people is for a point of reference. Okay, but do you guys think that Kanye is like in a good place tonight? He's got the coolest shoes. Who has Yeezys on in here? How many people have Yeezys on in here? A couple people have Yeezys on in here, right? I mean, his little, what is that, Jesus is King album? People be bumping that for a long time on repeat, right? Chick-fil-A song. It's got a little, what's his name? Who is the sax player that I like? Kenny G. That's my favorite song. Use this gospel. Na, na, na. Anyways, do you know what I'm saying? Guys, he has a lot of money. He has a lot of money. He had a beautiful wife, a lot of kids. You know what I'm saying? Only wisdom gives a long and a good life, riches, honor, pleasure, and peace. See, it's not what you have, it's how you got it. Matthew 6:33 says, when you seek first the kingdom. Well, how do I seek first the kingdom right now? Come to church on a regular basis. Learn to spend time with God every single day and obey what his word says. If you'll start that now and make that the habit of your life, make that the priority of your life, he will add everything else to you. Wisdom is a tree of life. to those who eat her fruit. Happy is the man who keeps on eating it. With them on guard, you can sleep without fear. I like this so much in the Message Bible. Switch there. It says you'll travel safely. You'll neither tire nor trip. Do not fear getting in a car accident. Do not fear that. From this night forward, in the name of Jesus, do not fear that. Commission the angels of God to encamp around about you. Well, how can you be sure? I can be sure because he surrounds me. I can be sure because he satisfies me with the long life. I'm in his plan. He needs me on earth. I have a job to do. Right? Even Paul, when he was shipwrecked because he had told the people that were holding him prisoner not to go and they went anyway, God still sustained him. Nobody in the shipwreck died. No people died. They lost all the cargo, but nobody died. Paul literally was in a good mood in the shipwreck when everyone else is freaking out. Why? Because he knew God told me to go here. He wouldn't have told me to go there if I wasn't going to get there. So everybody in that boat was spared. You know what I'm saying? Like, I face hard times. They just roll right off of me. The things the enemy tried to do to take me out, to discourage me, to get me to quit. You know what I want to say to him? Hit me with your best shot, bro. Hit me with. Exactly. Fire away. Bring it. That's not going to work. That's not going to work. Because according to Colossians 2:15, you've already been stripped and spoiled of all your power. It's not going to work on me. You made a wrong move when you killed Jesus. And once you did that, you've been defeated ever since. So I'm not falling for your lies. I'm not falling for your games. I'm not falling for your temptation. I'm not falling for your fear. I know what this word says. You can tell the path you are on. So have faith in the path you are on. Leave that statement up for them. But let me read to you what it says in the Message. It says, you'll travel safely. You'll neither tire nor trip. You'll take afternoon naps. Come on, somebody, say amen. Amen. And show your parents that verse. But do your homework first. You'll take afternoon naps without a worry. You'll enjoy a good night's sleep. No need to panic over alarms or surprises. Pandemic, plandemic, whatever. I'm not freaking out. Or predictions that doomsday's just around the corner. No more food. Well, I'll just grow my own, or I'll just eat protein shakes. We're gonna figure something out. Do you know what I mean? Like, I'm not gonna starve to death. It's not gonna happen. No need to panic over alarms or surprises or predictions that doomsday's just around the corner. Why? Because God will be right there with you. He will keep you safe and sound. See, there's a reward for being in his family. There's a reward for doing things his way in his family. I want you to bow your head and close your eyes. You might be here today.